Citizens of Thebes, I come bearing a brief but terrible tale. I was with our beloved Queen Jocasta, and then she died. I cannot tell you how, for Oedipus burst in on us with a cry. And we had no chance to watch her agonies. We had eyes for none but him, as he ran from one to another, demanding a sword, and where he might find his mother. In his frenzy, he was guided by some power, more than human, not by any of us who stood there. With a dreadful cry, as though a hand had pointed, he sprang at the double doors, forced back the bolts till the sockets gave, and ran into the room. And there inside we saw the woman hanging, her body swinging in a twist of rope. When he saw her, a shuddering cry welled up inside him. He cut the noose that held her. He tore the golden brooch from her dress and plunged it into his eye. Such horrors I saw. Blood spurted down his cheeks. It did not fall in slow and sluggish drops, but all at once, black blood came pouring like a shower of hail. He shouts for the doors to be opened, for every man in Thebes to see his father's murderer. He means to cast himself from Thebes, to stay in this house no more. But his strength is gone. He needs someone to guide his steps. The pain is more than he can bear. And this, too, he will show you. See, the doors are opening, and soon you will see a sight to move your tears.
Oh, the pain! Where do my poor legs take me? Where do the wild winds scatter my words? Oh, fate, where have you leapt with me? Take me away from these lands, my friends. Take me away with all the speed you may. For Oedipus is no more. Mom? The door's locked. Where do my poor legs take? Where are my poor legs taking me?